That's the Amazon jungle, 14,000 feet below. And this is the rugged terrain of Alaska. Neither these nor any spot on Earth lie beyond the reach of the airplane. But the problem always has been how to land men, machinery and supplies where there is no runway, nor even a clearing in the trees. Here is the answer to that problem. The crane helicopter, or sky crane, aptly called a universal transport vehicle, able to deliver the goods anywhere. This particular aircraft is the S-60, a research vehicle built to demonstrate the sky crane concept. It is, in briefest terms, a helicopter with the cabin cut away to permit the carrying of external cargoes. The S-60 uses the proven piston engine, rotor blades, and other dynamic parts of the Sikorsky S-56 helicopter. Future sky cranes will have the lighter, more powerful gas turbine engines. Visibility is excellent from the pilot's cabin. The pilot may change his position to face aft in flight using a duplicate set of controls. Thus, he obtains a clear view of the cargo during pickups or deliveries. Where hookups can be made on the ground, the sky crane may carry its cargo on a four-point suspension called the hard points. Where the terrain prevents landings or takeoffs, the sky crane uses a winch, cargo hook, and 100-foot cable to pick up or deposit its cargo. As a universal tactical vehicle, the sky crane has almost unlimited military uses. It is a prime mover, like a locomotive, or truck tractor, or towboat. But whirling through the air, it needs no rails, roads, waterways, or dock facilities. It could replenish ships at sea. Attaching an experimental people pod, for instance, permits swift movement of troops to battle objectives, lifting them up and over natural barriers that have halted armies since time began. Simple, lightweight isolators between pod and airframe make the pod vibration-free, a major breakthrough in the helicopter art. The pod's floor is the only load-carrying member, so as many openings as are needed may be cut in the walls without causing structural problems. This feature makes for easy exit from the pod, shown here as the troops leave quickly through side and rear doors. Pods are easily developed for any type of load requiring internal stowage. Even a helicopter cannot land here. But the sky crane, with its winch and cargo hook, delivers a 105mm gun with pinpoint accuracy. This method can be used wherever landings or takeoffs are not feasible. In mountains, woods, or aboard ship. The sky crane provides a new mobility for missiles, freeing them from road or rail transportation. It can even prepare and supply missile launching sites in locations that otherwise would be inaccessible. This Honest John missile, carried on the hard points, receives a vibration-free ride, vital to a missile's sensitive instrumentation. Here is how the sky crane transforms logistics problems from days into hours. When Sikorsky's overhaul and repair department was transferred to a new location, 5 air miles across Bridgeport Harbor, this was the problem. how to move 16 non-flyable Army H-34 helicopters weighing 4 tons each to the new site without delay in the vital modernization work being done on them. The Sky Crane moved all 16 in 2 hours, 20 minutes of flight time, with no interruption of the production schedule. By truck, the job would have taken at least 6 days, with the overhaul program thrown far off schedule. The S-60 has successfully shown its ability to perform many other military missions, at sea as well as over land. Some of these missions are classified. Civil defense is another job tailor-made for the Sky Crane's vertical lift capabilities. In event of nuclear attack, in floods or storms, with airports and roads unusable, the helicopter would offer the only means of reaching devastated areas with food, water, and medicine. In this test demonstration, a civil defense unit made use of the S-60 to airlift fire apparatus directly to the scene of a fire. In another demonstration, the Sky Crane airlifts men and equipment to clear a wooded area for construction of a power transmission line. The pod, quickly detached, will serve as a field office and living quarters during the job. It could just as well be a military command post with excellent visibility, or a field hospital, or a radio or radar outpost. For the Sky Crane cares nothing about the shape or size of the burden it carries. The Sky Crane takes off to pick up another cargo. A bulldozer arrives and is quickly unhooked. The Sky Crane can carry a load of any size or shape, the only limitation being weight. The S-60 carries 5 tons. Installing turbine engines will raise that capacity to 8 tons. Next comes a truck as the machinery for the clearing job accumulates. The Sky Crane can carry heavier, bulkier loads than the conventional cabin helicopter, and can do it faster and at less cost. Riding smoothly beneath the Sky Crane, a platform of fuel drums arrives, and with the dump truck technique, is quickly unloaded. This is typical of the speed with which Sky Crane cargoes are handled. The airlift completed, the crew goes to work. And the trees begin to fall. Towing this tree is easy for the S-60, which can pull loads as heavy as 35 tons. The load could just as well be a barge or a large ship, or a bulldozer, or a truck mired in the mud. In event of nuclear attack, the crane could clear debris from highways, thus opening up evacuation routes. More trees fall as the clearing job progresses. Summoned for special duty, the sky crane lowers its cargo hook. And the pilot, using the reversed seat and extra controls, guides the helicopter into position. A large tree comes up. And, weather cocking in the slipstream, flies through the air with the greatest of ease. Tree is released, and the sky crane is ready for its next assignment. The sky crane shows its lifting capacities, as well as the precision with which it may be maneuvered, as it sets a heavy load of logs neatly in the truck. Lift and precision like this would make it easy for the sky crane to supply ships at sea, or to perform all manner of construction jobs, such as setting power line poles, placing bridge spans in position, or erecting prefab houses. By carrying a wide variety of cargoes, the S-60 has given a good indication of the heavy-duty jobs to be done by larger, more powerful sky cranes of the future. A big utility trailer is quickly hooked up and lifted. As in the case of the pods, this shows the sky crane's use as a prime mover, a single vehicle able to carry many kinds of loads. Cement blocks, packed in an open pod or bin, are unloaded by the dump truck technique. Breakage averaged only one block per hundred. This cargo, like many of those lifted, was carried on four hard points, rather than on the single point suspension used with the winch and cargo hook. With the cement blocks deposited and the bin detached, the sky crane is now ready for another cargo. Without delay, it moves over a few feet to pick up a platform of firefighting equipment. A novel operation called kneeling enables the sky crane to pick up loads, taxi with them, and make normal or even emergency landings with the cargo still in place. Temporary removal of hydraulic fluid from the landing gear struts drops the X-60 into the kneeling position over the cargo. The cargo is hooked on. Then the sky crane's rotor blades lift slightly to take the weight off the landing gear. The fluid flows back into the struts, raising the load clear of the ground. And the sky crane taxis off with its cargo. Just another example of the versatility inherent in the sky crane. A quick dip in the river and the sky crane, using its hoist, scoops up 700 gallons of water, which is ready for a fast flight anywhere for emergency use. No traffic problems here as the automobile hitches a ride far above the parkway. The car comes in for a smooth landing and, back in its natural element, is driven away. The demonstrations you have seen provide but a hint of the sky crane's potential. What of the future? Aeronautical pioneer Igor Sikorsky tells about the sky cranes of tomorrow.
The scenes we have shown here provide only a hint of the potential of the crane helicopter. They permit us to visualize the virtually countless number of services and missions which they can render to our military as well as to commercial forces. In line with any other helicopter, the crane helicopter obviously is not in need of any roads or huge airfield for its operation. However, in contrast with any other vehicle known to man, the crane helicopter has no limitation whatsoever with respect to the length or bulk or size of the cargo which it can suspend and support underneath. Therefore, the only limitation that is left is its lifting capacity. And in this respect, considerable further progress can be confidently expected. This vehicle, which you can see represented by this model, is our next type, the S-64 crane helicopter, which is using the same well-tested and proven component part, transmission, controls, blades, and so forth, but is powered with two turbines, and consequently would have a payload lifting capacity in excess of 8 tons. And much larger vehicles are still feasible. We are now studying a crane with a lifting capacity of 20 tons, and still greater vehicles could make their appearance as soon as there would be need. I have every confidence that the most important and most valuable future may be expected for the crane helicopter, both with respect to the military as well as with respect to commercial services which it can render.
In the murky dawn of January 27, 1967, a Sikorsky S-61N helicopter landed a work crew on the deck of a cargo vessel anchored in Long Island Sound off Fairfield, Connecticut. This was the first step in an exercise which was to open the eyes of military and commercial transport interests to a revolutionary new system for the delivery of overseas cargo. The system, developed jointly by American exportist Branson Lines and the Sikorsky Aircraft Division of United Aircraft Corporation, is designed for use in unimproved areas or wherever port and docking facilities are either inadequate, non-existent, or overcrowded. The concept is simple. Cargo is containerized at point of origin and transported overseas in conventional container ships. Overseas, the vessel drops anchor offshore from an inland receiving point. Offloading of the cargo is handled by helicopter, a Sikorsky S-64 sky crane, which picks up the containerized load and flies it inland to its terminal point. In this demonstration, staged for United States military, congressional, and shipping officials, the container ship is owned by American exportist Branson and is currently serving the cargo trade between the United States and Europe. The land base, 5 nautical miles from the ship, was Sikorsky Aircraft's heliport at Bridgeport, Connecticut. During the 5.5 hour exercise, the sky crane, in continuous shuttle flights, offloaded 31 containers, weighing up to 20,000 pounds, an average of 6 loads per hour for a total of 462,000 pounds of cargo. Refueling and change of pilots were accomplished in the 5.5 hours. The average round trip was 9 minutes and 36 seconds. Storm warnings were up throughout the day. The container ship rode at anchor in 8-foot seas, and the sky crane bucked winds of up to 50 knots with gusts. Despite these conditions, the demonstration was performed without incident in the time interval originally projected. In this new system, the containerized cargo is stacked in vertical cells in the hold of the vessel. During offloading operations, a shipboard traveling gantry crane lowers its spreader into the cell, locks onto the container, and raises it to the deck. This is done while the helicopter is on its prior delivery mission. The gantry places the container in a pre-designated liftoff area where it is readied by the shipboard crew for pickup. On its return to the ship, the sky crane hovers over the load while it is secured to the cargo sling. The sky crane's cockpit contains an aft-facing seat and auxiliary flight controls, which give the pilot complete visual and manual control of loading operations. In a matter of seconds, another container is airborne toward its inland destination. This system offers many advantages for both military and commercial application. The cellular construction of the container ship permits cargo to be stowed in one of two ways. Individual cells can be loaded according to port of discharge, or cells can be loaded according to commodity, such as clothing, rations, or ammunition. For selection and offloading in any sequence to meet priorities or changing conditions, the savings in time are particularly rewarding. With conventional shipping methods, for example, it currently averages 43.5 days to move critical military cargo from San Francisco to a distribution point in Vietnam. Using the helicopter-container ship combination, this time can be cut by 53% to 20.5 days. Loads can be discharged from the vessel directly by air to a variety of inland points, such as airfields or rail and trucking depots. Multiple handling of the shipment is reduced, thereby minimizing the possibilities of pilferage or damage. And delivery by air eliminates the need for extensive docking facilities and port handling personnel, as well as the need for highway construction into the interior. Thank you.
those items of cargo not suited to shipment in standard containers, a new container known as a gondola is used. This load of fuel drums is an example. The gondola is also used for transporting jeeps, half-tracks, or other wheeled vehicles. The gondola has extendable corner posts which can be adjusted from 4 feet to 8 feet in height, according to the dimensions of the cargo. Both standard containers and gondolas are constructed to accommodate loads of up to 10 tons. Since it is the only helicopter in the free world capable of lifting a 10-ton payload, the S-64 is the only copter that can offer total performance in the container ship airlift system. The S-64 was designed as a basic lifting device and can carry a heavier load than a conventional helicopter of comparable size. It is equipped with a winch capable of hoisting or lowering a 10-ton load attached to the cargo hook. From a hover as high as 100 feet, it can pick up or deposit loads in terrain or in confined areas. The container ship helicopter system has been shown to be financially and technically sound. The vessels and the aircraft are operational today, and the marriage of the two for the cargo mission can be accomplished in a matter of months. All that is needed is the go-ahead. In Vietnam, the infantryman, as he has been through history, is still the backbone of our defense and offense. He walks, he patrols, through tangled, treacherous terrain. He scouts for and skirmishes with an enemy who is both everywhere and nowhere. Who is here today, flushed out tomorrow, and returns to ambush on the next day. But in this war, as in no other war, the foot soldier is supported by a second army. Motorized and mechanized, made up of an infinite variety of weapons, machines, vehicles, and aircraft. Their mission? To provide mobility, the rapid deployment of men and materiel. Among the many types of aircraft operational today in Southeast Asia, one of the most unique is the Sikorsky CH-54A flying crane helicopter, flown by the United States Army's 478th Aviation Company heavy helicopter in support of the 1st Cavalry Division Air Mobile. The flying cranes have a payload of 10 tons, far beyond that of any other helicopter in the area. And they are solving a wide variety of logistics problems in a way that would have astonished military planners a few short years ago. A typical problem is setting up installations in hard-to-reach areas. It may be an airstrip, a campsite, a supply depot. The site, wherever it is, has to be cleared and graded. This requires earth-moving equipment. Earth movers are heavy, but the flying crane airlifts such equipment with ease, up and over the tropical vegetation, the hills and valleys, and the ever-present rice paddies. Bulldozers, road graders, trucks or tractors, they all get to their destination swiftly by the heavy lift helicopters. To keep the Mobile Army on the move, fueling and refueling of its vehicles is a continuous requirement. Here, the flying crane hoists a load of 2,000 gallons of fuel in four cells for delivery to the forward areas. Food, cigarettes, clothing, ammunition, you name it. The supply lines have to be kept open. The CH-54 can transport a bigger load of these necessities than any other helicopter. Weapons of war, too, have to be quickly deployed to deliver fire on shifting enemy concentrations. One of the crane's important assignments is moving heavy artillery pieces. This 155mm howitzer with ammo weighs 14,000 pounds, well within the crane's capacity. It is delivered to the battle zone while other helicopters fly in troops and lighter support equipment. The flying cranes have saved millions of dollars in retrieving aircraft downed in remote areas by enemy action or mechanical failure. Before the cranes entered service, aircraft of the size and weight of this CH-46 helicopter had to be destroyed or abandoned to the enemy. Now they can be recovered, airlifted to repair stations, and either restored to flying status, or, if too severely damaged, their usable components can be salvaged as replacement parts in other aircraft. In their first 18 months of service, three flying cranes retrieved over 150 aircraft, both helicopters and fixed wing having a total value estimated at some $80 million. Almost all were repaired and returned to duty. The crane is also designed to carry portable vans or pods, which are readily adaptable to a variety of purposes. One such pod is a fully equipped command post, complete with lights, desks, and communication equipment. Others may be outfitted as maintenance shops, field kitchens, or troop carriers. Perhaps the most important application of the special purpose pod is this airborne field hospital, which can bring vital medical equipment directly into the combat area and provide on-the-spot medical attention to the wounded. The unit is air-conditioned and has its own electrical power units and high-intensity lighting. It contains X-ray and laboratory equipment, surgical instruments and supplies, a blood bank and operating tables. The seriously wounded can be treated or operated on immediately, saving the precious minutes or hours that would be required to transport them to a base hospital miles away. These are but a few of the missions being performed by this remarkable helicopter in Southeast Asia. The usefulness of the CH-54 flying crane is multiplying almost daily as military tacticians find other missions that the Big Bird can do as no other aircraft can.